I'm Dave Monig.
I'm Ryno.
And we're here with Coast Airbrush TV.
Yeah.
We got something really cool to show you guys today.
Yeah, what's really cool is this Black Ops thing I came up with. I was hanging out with Franco, our tattoo friend. All their tattoo machines are actually custom colored. So right. I figured, why couldn't we bring that over with the airbrush?
Great idea.
It was a great idea. I experimented with my guns. We got the coating in there, and we actually tried to figure out a way to make it work for the airbrush for solvent base.
Exactly. That's the call that we tend to get when people first see these colored airbrushes. They say, hey, how durable is that finish?
They are extremely durable.
Very durable.
I have put them to the test. I am known to beat the crap out of guns.
Yes.
Yes, I am.
So not only are they very durable, but some of the other points that we can touch base on is also the grip, right, Ryno?
It feels completely different. It's actually, the chrome has a cold feel to it. And it's a little slippery, right?
Right, especially when you start painting in a hot room.
Uh-huh.
Hand gets a little sweaty.
But the thing about it, too, is actually it feels like a grip. And actually can control the trigger a little bit better because it's got that coating on it.
Right, so you've got the grip, you've got the cool colors, and we've come up with a lot of really cool names, I think, too.
Oh, yeah, I mean, that was the fun part
about it. The Stormtrooper, the Tiffany,
right.
You know, Frankenslime, El Diablo.
One of my favorites here.
I don't think that we've stopped yet, either. I think we're going to keep coming out with new colors and new types of names.
With custom colors, you can do everything. I mean, we're going in with the camouflage
now. I'm loving the camouflage.
Dude, that's great, because now, see, you have your black and your white, but you can do your camouflage. That's great.
And what if you want to go in the woods or in the jungle and airbrush?
Well, it depends on Dave's got a point there, yeah. Wildlife scenes.
The other question that we get a lot here, too, is for people that do buy the colored airbrushes, they want to know about parts or replacement parts. We don't currently have those on our website as of yet during this video shoot, but we will in the future, and all of the parts are available upon request. So if you do damage one of the parts, we can make it for you, and we'll get it right out to you, right?
Yeah, exactly. Actually, that's what's great about it. We'll have an arsenal of parts ready to go once this gets going.
Yeah. Some of the other features that a lot of our customers have pointed out to us, actually, Ryno, is that when they're actually working on detailed pieces, and sometimes the chrome, it can glare off of their studio light, and it puts a reflection right into the detail portion of where they're painting.
So as you can see from the camera, there is no glare. You can see it on
no
the chrome.
No glare at all.
You can't see it on the... That's
and
a great
made
point.
Them, we've made them to that matte finish for that reason, as well as the grip. The way that these are actually coated is this is an aftermarket product for Iwata. I want to kind of stress that this is not through Iwata Media, but it is through Coast Airbrush as an exclusive. So it's an aftermarket add-on.
We went through all this ourselves,
yes,
the whole trial and tribulations of testing this product out on our own.
We will warranty that as well, even much further after the sale. We've noticed that the durability of this coating is just to the extreme.
It's awesome.
We've had no issues whatsoever with any kind of solvent. Now, they aren't indestructible, so you can't run over them with a train or throw them from an airplane expect them not to chip.
Well, you can scratch chrome. Chrome scratches too, so what's the difference between a coating or chrome?
Exactly.
Paper plastic.
Destroyed.
Right.
Overall, if you have a problem with the coating or you feel it's peeling off, we take care of it. You can send your gun right back in and we can take it down to the process that we do now. And that is a unique process that we do use to make these rhino-proof.
Right. Exactly.
I know that if Rhino's been able to use these airbrushes for a while, then I could put my stamp on there. No problem. We'll warranty that for sure.
Exactly.
Sorry, Ryan.
No problem. Hey, I'm known for that. I'm showing you. See me on TV beating them up. So
yes,
I'm known for
this.
Yes,
I do.
That's why we came up with this.
So the process in which we take the airbrushes completely down and we media blast them with a particular type of sandblasting material. That's right, so that we can improve the adhesion of the coating. The coating is also a proprietary coating that we use with a certain amount of catalyst, and it's baked in an oven for a certain amount of time. What that does is it gives us this protective coating. So not only is it durable, but it gives us that matte finish so that we can achieve that grip.
So basically what we're saying is don't try it at home.
Well, yeah. I haven't had a couple people out there say, oh,
I'm sure you could.
I saw one thread online once where somebody actually recommended that you could just spray one shot on top of the gun.
I don't think that's going to work too well.
If any of you have ever used an enamel before, you know how messy that would be if any solvent got
so. Right. And I'm known as a solvent-based painter, so I leave my guns with solvent-based paint in there for weeks on end. I've actually taken Scotch-Brite. And if you want to go see him, we can go next door anytime you want and see these guns in action.
I think we should do that. Yeah. But before we do, let's talk about also the fact that we can do the spray guns. Now, this is the Black Ops, and originally we started with just blacking these out.
Money.
And that's where the name Black Ops originally kind of came from. And now it's kind of morphed into more of what we call the Ryno Signature Series.
So that's the same thing with the airbrush. I mean, when you're a custom painter, you have multiple guns. You have a clear gun, you got a white, you got a black, you got metallics, you got other guns, you got primer guns. You want to make sure you have the color in the gun so you don't mess up your paint job.
And that's a great point, Ryno. Quite often when I'm in the back over there, we're using each other's guns. It's great to see that you have your transparent black in one gun and your other black in another gun, your solid black, and just your different colors that you kind of get used to what's in each of the guns. Light colors might go in your monster. Monster. Dark colors might go on your Platinum. Other specialty colors that you use a lot of might go on the Haunt. You know, all of the different names, and just to be able to identify them quickly on the fly.
You'll be able to see them in the shop next door, and I have them set up in colors next door.
I think we should go over there and take a look at it.
Let's go check it out.
But before we do, I got one other cool item to kind of touch base on.
You told me about this a
little
bit.
Not only do we have the spray guns in multiple colors, and of course Black Ops, but we have this new product from Aluma 3, and it is called the Aurora. The Aurora is an amazing new device. Now, everyone's seen a sun gun. Okay, and that's where we can actually check our colors, especially with our metallics and our pearls as we're spraying. This is actually just that. This is going to be like a sun gun, but on the actual spray gun. They make this for the line of Iwatas, all the way from the Supernova, which is one particular model, all the way to the LPH 400 series. And then we also have it for the Sada, which we do offer, the Tecna, the Velvis, and some other guns as well. So this is a really unique product. It comes with two rechargeable batteries. It does also come with a charger, and it is solvent resistant. That's right. It is a solvent resistant 3-ounce device that just goes right onto your gun. So
did
it's
you
extremely
say it's
lightweight.
It's carbon fiber too, right?
It's made of carbon fiber, so that's what brings up the 3 ounces of the total weight, even
so
with the battery. It's
great.
Very light. You barely know it's on there. Mm-hmm. Now, one of the cool features that you pointed out, Ryno, is when you told me you were spraying the other day and you were doing a lower panel.
Sometimes you're not in the booth. It's not the greatest lighting. And you want to make sure you get your panels right and you're spraying right. And you don't want to pull out in the sun and go, oops.
And that's the Achilles heel of painting
right there is
a car.
Right. Yeah.
Is the lower curved panel. And even the nicest booths with the nicest lighting don't have a lot of light that gets underneath there. So with this device, you're actually able to do that. You can actually flip the light on and you've got this bright, intense light, which is 4,600K, and it's a 500 lumen. So it's basically what that means is that it's a bright light that is true to the natural sunlight. So it's going to depict with this light what you would see in a bright, natural sunlight.
That's pretty cool.
It is very, very cool. So that's a nice added feature
we'll put one next door. Let's try it out.
And that's exactly
I got a couple cars coming up. So let's go next door.
Well, let's go next door and just check out the durability and the actual work environment of these guns so you guys can see what we've put them through.
Yeah, this isn't staged, so let's go next door and check it out.
Let's do it. Well, okay, here we go.
Here they are. Here's my magic right here. As you can see, they're in action. I got them lined up from white to color to black. And you can see that with straight white, I got white in the gun. But with the camo gun, I've got a different a darker white in there as well, with yellow, brown in these. And two different colors for these, two different colors for these, light and dark.
I love it.
It's magic.
Dark black and a transparent black.
Yeah, it's great.
And I noticed, see how Rhino's here, he's got even some chrome parts on some of his guns, like on the Strict Black Ops. A lot of our customers, as we've kind of talked about, are kind of Mr. Potato Heading a lot of their guns that they do buy.
That's so. This is the cab. Yeah, I love this. I love chrome.
The chrome and white.
Chrome and
awesome
color's looking. Cool, man. The matte's cool too, but I like chrome as well.
So I notice a lot of you guys out there, and that's what kind of the Black Ops Army is doing, is showing us a lot of these different combinations and pictures of all their different pieces and
what
parts
can you
on
come
each
up
gun.
With?
Yeah, so they are interchangeable, so why not?
Yeah, why not? And the same thing applies from here over to my spray guns as well. I go from light to dark. You can see, because when I'm doing graphics, I got 10 different colors going at one time.
Yep.
You can see around me, I have 8 different projects going on, and each one of these represents a color that's in one of these projects.
It's great. It's so quickly identifiable. You can just go right over there. We know what's the clear gun.
Exactly.
We know what's the secondary color gun for graphics. We know what the touch-up guns are, what nozzle size is in them.
I want to even show you another really cool trick, that these are so durable that I actually antiqued one of them just to try to play with it. And this was actually done with 400 grit, and that's how much aggressiveness you had to do to take the coating off. So if you want to talk about durability, durability's right here. I mean, I've actually cleaned
Very
these
impressive.
Guns with lacquer thinner and red scotch brite.
We do put the care in the prep.
Don't do it all the time.
Prep is everything. You know, the particular media blast that we put on these things to get them to that, to etch that good for the coating to stick, we put a lot of care into that.
Yep, exactly. They're money. I mean, I couldn't stand by a better coating on a gun to make it cool.
And they're all still smooth. The trigger action? Not affected one bit.
Right.
Completely smooth.
Right. So,
that's great, Ryno.
There you go.
I mean, there you have it. Seeing is believing, as they say. And these guns, I can attest, since day one, since we've been doing the Black Ops, have been dropped, beaten. I mean,
and these are my own guns. So these are actually, you guys got new guns. These are used guns that I've actually taken and beat the crap out of already.
And then we Black Ops'd them. Yeah.
So that is even showing more how much more durable they are.
You know, you bring up another really good point. Is a lot of people actually want to know if we can actually coat their guns. One of the criteria that we have for that is that when you do send us your gun, We do have to charge a little bit more, of course.
For cleaning, some of course, cleanup and right, stuff. It's not new.
But what we're gonna do too is we're gonna test the gun before we coat it. We need to make sure as you send us your airbrush that it's in proper working condition before we coat it.
So parts and
all
that
stuff
should be
replaced. And we are not responsible for anything
right?
after the fact other than the coating. So what we'll do is we'll actually test your airbrush beforehand before we do the coating, and then of course we reassemble after the coating, test it again to make sure that it's up to our standards to ship back to you.
Yeah, sounds like a great idea. Yeah. I mean, cover yourself. That's right. Don't want them to go bad.
We're only a phone call away. If you have any detailed questions, you can obviously email us or you can call us, and we'll talk to you about the coatings and what the combinations are. And even for some of the people out there that want us to go to the extreme to do some other custom coatings colors and textures, we do that as well. We just haven't really advertised as much of that because we're trying to really stay caught up.
We're still learning as we go. We're still experimenting. We got other cool colors coming out, like you said earlier.
I love it, man.
And that's what's great. I got to say about Coast Airbrush is that they do take the time to come and answer your questions, take care of you, and you're not just a customer giving money. They're actually out there to help you.
Thank you, Ryno.
Answer your questions, and I love Coast Airbrush, man.
Thank you so much.
My best friend.
that's a given.
But anyway, yeah. Hey, give him a call.
There you go. Seeing is believing. I hope you guys enjoyed taking a little tour here and seeing the durability of these fine instruments.
Now I'm going to get back to work.
Let's go. Well, there we go. You guys got to see the guns in a working environment.
Welcome to my shop and my working environment. You got to see these guns actually with paint in there. They're well used, but they're lined up accordingly and organized to where I know where my lights, my darks, my colors are at. They're all set up to make it beneficial and easy to work with.
That's what's great. I'll just reiterate that one more time. As Ryno said, having a gun for every color is awesome. We encourage people to have a lot of guns in their arsenal, but nothing's more important than really having a black gun, a white gun, a light-colored gun and a dark-colored gun. Yeah. And then you can add on. You can start adding on some of the cool names and some of the cool colors as you start to have other colors that you use a lot of, right?
I mean, you can have a chrome color and a color and a colored gun. I mean, that's fine. As long as you start with one color, it's good with us, right?
And we're always adding colors. We're always coming up with new names and new colors. And we're currently offering a lot of the spray guns, the touch-up guns, even the bottom-fed BCS right here. The Micron series.
I mean, you're going from the Micron 2 all the way up to the Supernova.
Yes.
I mean, anything you can think of is there waiting to get black-topped out.
Yep. And of course, the HPCS series. You know, the Eclipses are our industry standard. It is the staple for our marketplace. And that's where we kind of started with all the signatures.
That's the workhorse airbrush right there. So right on.
It's great.
Thanks for having me over. Thanks for checking this out. I appreciate the opportunity to do the Black Ops.
We do have also on Facebook, too. There's a Black Ops Army.
That's right. Black Ops Army.
So there is a Black Ops Army user group.
Yeah. Like it.
It's kind of fun to see people from all over the country and, you know, some of the languages and stuff
that come in. We got one from France. We got them all over the place.
Yeah, it's really cool to see how many people have collected them. It's neat to see how many people have collected them and kind of sent their pictures in of them being in use and stuff.
Right.
I love it. It is, again, like I said, this is a Coast Airbrush exclusive. It's an aftermarket product that we put on to the Iwata airbrushes. So it is a Coast exclusive. If you have any warranty issues or anything like that, please feel free to contact us.
Don't call me. Call Coast.
That's right. You can call Coast Airbrush. I'm Dave Modding, though, for Coast Airbrush TV.
I'm Ryno. Thanks for watching.
And we both thank you, and we'll see you again real soon.
Rock on.